Well, hello. See if we can get that to go up there a bit more. That's a Yardwatcher. He's a 35 watt phone beater. Five. Aye, and as you can see, gives off a lovely golden light. Let me get that. I had to get a bracket. If you can see up here. What they're called, light and energy distribution. You can probably see it. It's about there. People who make the bloody street lamps. Because nothing else would fit. And yeah, anyone who's like watched my channel has probably realised I've had that thing. It's bloody 2016 or something, but I've just had it in the house to play with and that. And I kind of got out of sentimental reasons when they got these LED things coming along. I managed to, when they were putting them up, I managed to go up the truck and so you can have some of them. So I've got a couple more in the garage there. No, the thing about these is those new lampposts, the heads on them, they must be something like £600-£700 each. And these things were perfectly good. And lo and behold, they must have spent about 80, I think the figure was 83 million. They spent Northumberland County Council. Now this is probably the same of other councils around the country. And it's going to take the equivalent of a quarter of a century or more to pay back in energy savings for what they've paid shelled out for replacing all these bloody lampposts and lights with all these bloody things. And now you can get a proper bulb, LED bulb, just to fit them. Those lights cost about £500-£600 each. Well, the LED bulb that you can just put in there to replace the old Sox bulb is £35. Or £40. So I've got a couple more of these in the garage. I'm gonna probably later on do some like videos where I replace the old Sox bulb with one of them. But the thing about these is the light is actually a lot better for night driving and all sorts of things, so God knows why they replace them. Yeah, so you got LPS bulbs, low pressure sodium, that's why it gives off that sort of like orange yellow light. You only can see two colours, black and yellow. I think that's why they're so energy efficient for the day. I don't like coming out here and making videos in public late at night. It's not very good, is it? Yeah, I'm going to try and get some spare sodium bulbs. I'm going to put a sodium bulbs, keep this thing going for sentimental reasons. This kind of brings me back to, when I was growing up, street corners and things, back in the 80s and 90s and 70s. Anyway, I'm going to sit out here. I'll finish off this video inside. Hey, back in the house. I can talk normally here without thinking about people who might be listening and watching in. But I've just been going through a few of the options on the LED replacements. And one interesting fact is the Golden Gate Bridge in San Francisco. It was lit by Sox bulbs. So it would give part of its name Golden Gate with a golden light and everything. And when they came to replace them, they didn't want white lights, white bright lights on there, because it would ruin the appearance of the bridge. So while they were producing LED replacements for these bulbs, they specifically requested an orange warm or yellow warm LED for the bridge. And that is why you now have the option of not just white light, which is like your daytime light, which keeps people up at night and gives people headaches, but you can now actually get LED replacements for these lamps and things with the actual original yellow, orange, golden colour. Like they have on the, like they've replaced the lamps on the Golden Gate Bridge with. So when I get some of these LED replacement bulbs, I might try and get one of them to see what the difference between the original Sox lamp and this is like. But oh yeah, you got the prices here. I'll do a few screenshots here. 35 watt Sox bulb replacement is, yeah, I've got one for £33, different makes. There's a one for the bigger like highway lights, which used to have like 60 watt or 90 watt Sox bulbs in them. You get them for about between £50 and £75, the LED replacements. And what you do when I make the video of one of these is you got to just basically direct the current straight into the bayonet fitting for the bulb. and take out all the, basically bypass all the like ballast and stuff at the top that was put in there to make the Sox bulbs light. So there will be a little bit of modification you have to do. But the actual lamps out there, I've seen the new lamps, they're on sale for about £200-300. Smaller options, when you get the ones with the great big loads of light LEDs in them, they're still talking about £500-600. And you could have just put a bulb in for 35 and done the same thing. So where's all that money gone when there's homeless people that could have been housed and things for it? Sad, isn't it? Well, I think that's all for this one. And remember, the socks is with you. Remember to like and subscribe. See you guys later.